Thank you so much. How much sodium are you putting into your body that every day you're eating and you don't even know about it? And how much are you putting in your body when you're eating out? You know, March is National Nutrition Month, and we're taking a closer look at sodium. With us this morning is Erin Polinsky Wade. She's a registered dietitian specializing in heart disease and diabetes. Thank you so much for being in.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. So New York City is making this official push, right?
Right.
To have restaurants identify high sodium menus. So we decided to kind of show you really what we're consuming. So what do I have in my hand
right
here?
So right there you have the average American consumes about 3,400 milligrams of sodium per day. So
okay,
that's
I'm going to pour it out.
Right.
Ready?
There.
I'm going to pour it out. This is the...
So it's a... It's so much sodium right
okay.
there, whereas it's only supposed to be 2,300 milligrams a day or less. That's what we should be
and
taking
in. That's the recommended.
Right. And you can see how much more. And high sodium diets are linked with high blood pressure, heart disease, mm-hmm. and an increased risk of stroke. So we have to start cutting the salt.
Okay. When you're in restaurants, where are you getting it from?
Sure. So I have so many clients, they come into me and they say, I didn't put salt on my food. I didn't use the salt shaker. I'm eating a low sodium diet. But the truth is only 5% of the salt we take in is coming from the salt shaker.
Wow.
It's amazing. 94% is processed prepared foods. In a restaurant, it could be condiments, sauces, marinades, all sources of hidden sodium.
Salad dressing. So
yes.
Remember, marinades, salad dressing, sauces, all hidden sources of sodium.
Yes.
All right, so let's take a look at some typical meals that you have for us.
Yeah.
First of all, we have breakfast here. So what do you have and what can we explain to our viewers?
Sure. So say you go out and you're going to get a bran muffin and vegetable juice thinking you're making a great choice for
right.
breakfast. That bran muffin and vegetable juice has 1,277 milligrams of sodium in it. That's more than half the day just at breakfast alone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Instead, what is the choice?
So a better choice, instead of the bran muffin, go with a whole grain English muffin, put a little bit of low sodium nut butter, like an almond butter or a peanut butter,
mm-hmm.
and either do a low sodium vegetable juice or do 100% fruit juice instead.
Okay, and still filling and still good for you. So this is a better breakfast. So forget the bran muffin, go for the English muffin topped off with some peanut butter with some 100% fruit juice or seltzer. Mix it with seltzer. I always say cut it half and half. How about lunch? What do we have here?
So say you go to the restaurant and you say, I'm not going to have the pizza today. I'm going to get the salad. I'm going to do a healthy choice. Here you have a salad that has 2,845 milligrams of sodium, more than the whole day's allotment in one salad, where you're thinking you're making a good choice, but you're really getting a sodium bomb.
All right, so look at this, guys. This is all the extra sodium that you're eating in this so-called healthy salad. Don't do it. It's gonna eventually catch up to you. What is the better option?
So the reason the salad is so high is all the add-ons. It's the sodium in the dressing. It's the cheese. It's the nuts on top.
Sure.
So switch it up. Stick with the grilled chicken and the vegetable, but put some olive oil and
right.
vinegar. You have the salad here. You have unsalted nuts. You have fruit for flavor, but we're not adding the cheese, the croutons, the olives.
All right. Then we have dinner. Here's our option over here.
Right. So this is a turkey burger, and you might think a turkey burger
oh, yeah.
equals health.
But look at all this hidden salt in that turkey burger, everybody.
Exactly. Between the fries on the side, the condiments, ketchup, mustard, even pickles, and of course the bacon and the cheese, packed full of sodium. So instead of this, get the turkey burger, but stick with the grilled vegetables. Get the mushrooms, the onions, the tomato on top. Go light on the condiments, and you can cut the sodium in half.
I think the bottom line is you really have to prepare a lot of your meals and be prepared when you go outside to just get the steamed vegetables, the grilled
right.
vegetables. Use lemon, use olive oil.
Exactly.
Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah, I mean, you can absolutely flavor your food with less sodium. You can do fresh salsa instead of commercial salsa. Use the lemon juice. But don't be afraid to ask questions when you eat out. You know what's going into your food, because when you're informed, you can make the best decision.
Simply put, what is, and here's a ways that you can cut it down. Avoid the salt shaker. Skip the sauce on your entree. Get your salad dressing on the side. Go easy on the condiments and ask questions. I love that. Be prepared to ask questions, especially if you're somebody that has a diet that needs to be restricted. You want to have fun in life.
Right. And there's no reason to give up salt completely, but there's a lot of ways we can flavor our food without the sodium. We just have to make those simple swaps,
okay.
and you're healthier for it.
So where am I supposed to throw the salt, over my right shoulder or my left shoulder? My left. For good luck for all of you. I just did that for you. Mazel tov to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Of course, here is the book. For more health advice, we want you to check out her book. It's the 2-Day Diabetes Diet. Come on, everybody. If all the salt doesn't tell you a story that this is what we're putting in our bodies and this is what eventually is going to make us live a healthy life or not a healthy life, well, it's a wake-up call.
Definitely.